2 Timothy chapter 3 and verse 1, we read these words, "This know also that in the last days perilous times shall come." I personally believe that we are living in those perilous times. In these perilous times, the churches have two enemies, those from without and those from within. Under the moving of the Spirit of God, Paul wrote in Acts chapter 20 and verses 28 through 30, "Take heed therefore unto yourselves," speaking to the elders, the pastors of that church in Ephesus, "and to all the flock over the which the Holy Ghost hath made you overseer, to feed the church of God which he hath purchased with his own blood. For I know this, that after my departing shall grievous wolves enter in among you. These wolves are from without." Then he goes on saying, "not sparing the flock, also of your own selves," that is, those from within, that is, the pastors themselves, "shall men arise speaking perverse things to draw away disciples after them." Contemporary Christian music, which it's a misnomer, but it's one of the methods the devil is using in this Laodicean age. One such Christian organization among many using the CCM is what is known as the Orange Conference. Reggie Joyner was one of the founding pastors of North Point Community Church, where Andy Stanley is now pastor. Joyner was the inspiration of what is known as the Orange Conference. Here is a 57-second clip from a recent Orange Conference. With you to decide whether or not that clip represents godly music or not, but God's word tells us in Ephesians 5:19, "speaking to yourselves in psalms and hymns and spiritual songs, singing and making melody in your heart to the Lord." Charles Haddon Spurgeon, commenting on this verse, said, and I quote, "Men filled with wine call for a song. And when believers are exhilarated by the divine spirit, they also should have their singing. But they must choose the songs of Zion, such as the Lord himself will account to be true melody." End of quote. May the Lord's churches keep themselves from the sounds of the world, so that he might present it to himself a glorious church, not having spot or wrinkle or any such thing, but that it should be holy and without blemish. Ephesians 5:27.